What's up, everyone? Back again. Today I'm showing you how I made this. That track is Alison Wonderland, Bad Things. She has a brand new album out, really sick stuff. Highly recommend you check it out. And I want to show you how I made the drums, the bass, the leads. Before we go any further, for those who don't know, my name is Zach Edward. I teach music production here at Cosmic Academy, and we are an artist development program that's been around for about 10 plus years. We've worked with 500 plus students, and the results are remarkable. You know, they sign to some of the biggest labels like Toolrom, Spinnin, Anjuna, Armada. They play some of the biggest shows and festivals like EDC and Ultra. And the point of this YouTube channel is to offer some free content where we can hopefully help you see some of those results as well. So, without wasting any more time, let's hop into this. I want to show you what I learned, how to make these sounds, and I think you're going to pull a ton of value. Okay, first I'm going to play the original side by side with my remake, and in the comments, I want you to give me a score. How close was I to perfection? How close was I to the original? 10 being perfect, 0 being horrible. Leave a comment and let me know how close I was. Okay, so starting with the drums, they sound like this. Let's break it down element by element, pretty simple. Starting with a kick drum. Really just starting with a good sample. The processing wasn't doing too much. The one thing that stood out about the kick was that it had a ton of attitude and character. So for me, what I chose to do was just duplicate the kick and overprocess another version and fade it back in around the original kick, as you could see here. So let me show you what this attitude layer sounds like without processing and with. So you could see I'm achieving the crunch through using some Saturn, as well as the overdrive, tiny bit, only 5% on my dry wet here, and really pushing the sides up in the mix so it sounds like it's encompassing, like around the kick drum, surrounding it. I did hear on top of the kick, there was some high end, almost sounded like a shaker layered on top. Then we had a classic trap hip hop style snare. As far as the processing goes, you could see I'm just clipping it using these first two saturators, doing a little bit of EQ by boosting the high end, also putting a little bit of reverb, some room space on the snare. Finally, some simple hi-hats, just removing some low end, also boosting the high end with the MOG EQ. That's pretty much it with the drums. The only other cool thing was the kick fill at the end of the phrase, which I thought was pretty dope. Now, getting into the bass and lead layers, I have a big surprise for you. I've included these presets in the description below. You could download them for free, but I ask of one thing. Click the like button right now, help us out. And if you're not already subscribing, just do it. We're putting these videos out every day, high quality content. You can't beat it. You don't want to miss the next one. All right, so the first bass layer is going to be the Reese. And it sounds like this. With it playing, I'll also show you the MIDI. Now, getting into the synth, we only have two oscillators working. Both are playing saw wave. So an oscillator A, you can see I have a saw wave. Octave is pulled down one lower than the saw wave in oscillator B. Both are cranked up with some voices of unison. Obviously added some detune as well to give it that character and sound. on oscillator B as well, I've also gone ahead and removed the fundamental, so there is no low end on oscillator B. It's not getting in the way with the oscillator underneath it. If we jump to the bottom right corner, this being a bass layer, I don't want the notes to play on top of each other, so I do have the monophonic button engaged. I also have a bit of glide and portamento, so when the notes change, you could hear the pitch kind of glides from note to note. On the back tab, I do have a little bit of distortion, just some basic tube, drive is cranked up, mix is roughly at about 35%. So the version I'm going to show you here is the one I made with post-processing. The ones I've included in the description that you can go download for free right now, those are strictly just made within Serum. So they're going to sound a little bit different. I'm not going to lie, the post-processing ones do sound a little bit closer to the original, but the ones I've included for download, it's a one-stop shop. Everything is within Serum. All right, so first up was a little bit of OTT. Next was a little bit of an EQ boost doing some high shelf as well as a bump at about 4.8K on the Neve 1073. Finally, we clean up the high end using my favorite, the Dangerous Bax EQ. Very smooth. If you look in the bottom right, I also have two sidechains set up. One is to my kick drum, the other is to the snare. The sub is simple, it's playing the same MIDI and it sounds like this. As far as the synth itself, you could see I have a sub at -2, a saw wave above it, and we are filtering out the saw, which is above, so you don't hear too many of the overtones. I'm doing a little bit of compression using the distressor and opto mode, also just adding some of the distortion. I like the harmonics it adds. Notice I'm using sidechain with the utility plugin. So I'm literally just automating the volume around each kick. So I zoom in, I look at where the kick lies, and I duck my sub around that kick drum because my sub needs to stay clear of the tail in that kick. The tail is the lowest frequency, so I want to make sure my deep sub also ducks around those as well. Finally, we have the lead, so I'm going to let you hear it as well as look at the MIDI as it's playing. As soon as I heard this song, I first said, shit, how the hell am I going to figure out what these notes are? Once I got that down, though, I had an idea of how to make this sound right off the bat. So what I listened for is wave shape immediately, and it sounded like a square wave to me with just some sort of like redux or bit crusher on it. So I started with this square wave in oscillator A. You could see there are some voices of unison. I do have some detune turned up. Now, I also have oscillator B on a saw wave and a noise oscillator, but if I turn these off, you're going to notice there isn't much of a difference. In a way, they almost like dirty the sound a little more, which I had the hardest time achieving, is like getting it as dirty as the original was. Finally, I have a filter, which is being modulated by this envelope. I also have envelope 3 controlling some of the pitch mod up here. Now what this does is create a little bit more attack on the front of the sound. So what I do is I drag envelope 3 up to this coarse pitch adjustment, crank it up a bit, and now watch what happens if I start to increase my decay. If you keep this value short, it creates a quick pitch modulation at the very beginning of your sound, which almost adds a bit more attack. It's a really cool trick you can try. Up into the bottom right, we do have, again, a little bit of glide. I also have the mono button on so that the notes aren't bleeding over one another. And on the back tab, we do, once again, have some tube distortion. Now, the sound is really made with the post-processing, so let me show you what this does. First off, a little bit of EQ cleaning up some low end and the nasty highs. Next was the Purple Audio MC77 for me. I just went with a faster compressor, FET. I like the way this one sounds, really to balance things out. Flatten it out a little bit more. Next, we do have a little bit of reverb, which sounds like this. You're also going to notice that the reverb in the original tune was much more prominent in this section. Now, I believe it's because the notes themselves. Think about it. When you have so many notes arpeggiating one after another, you can't really have this longer prominent reverb because it's going to overlap the notes themselves. Where in this section, as the notes space out, we have more available room for the reverb to fill, and it sounds 10 times better. I'm then using Decimort 2, which is just a bit crusher, so you'll see what this adds. And I really just sifted through some presets. I kind of knew I wanted to use this plugin. I like the way it sounds. Found one that was somewhat similar to the original. It's probably not perfect. I'm also distorting again then using the RC20. Finally, we are going to break some rules and we're going to put OTT at the end of this and compress all of it, blowing up the reverbs, blowing up the effects. At the end of the chain, once again, we have sidechain, ducking around kick, and snare. That's it for this one. Hopefully you see how simple it was, and if there's one thing I've pulled from doing all these remakes week in and week out, is that simplicity always wins. Great songwriting, simple sound selection, but the right sounds, the ones that fit each other and complement each other. Don't forget, you can download the presets below in the description, and if you're gonna do so, throw us a like, subscribe to the channel. It's a great way to say thank you, and I look forward to catching you in the next video.